click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello guys, I welcome you to this video on transient analysis. We are into numericals and now we will concentrate on numerical number 10. So, you can see problem number 10 here. They have given us a network. In this network, the switch is closed at t equal to 0. Already it is given that there is 0 capacitor voltage and 0 inductor current initially. So, they are asking us to solve for V1, V2, d by dt of V1 and d by dt of V2 at t equal to 0 plus. So, we will just go back with normal procedure. So, our procedure is, our step number one is write and draw what happens at t equal to 0 minus. So, at t equal to 0 minus, we know that inductor will act as a short circuit and the capacitor will act as open circuit. So, we will draw that circuit first. So, at t equal to 0 minus, we can write it as a note so that we will not forget. So, inductor will act as short circuit. Capacitor will act as open circuit. Those who are confused with why they act as short circuit and open circuit, for them I will recommend to write the very first video on this chapter, that is initial conditions for inductor and capacitor. By viewing that video, you will have all your answers. So at t equal to 0 minus, we will substitute it. So we will draw the same circuit, switch will be open because we are writing at 0 minus and switch is closed at t equal to 0. So, there is a resistance of R1 and here it is R2. So, capacitor will become open circuit, inductor will become short circuit. So, this is short circuit and the capacitor is going to be open circuit. Well, this resistance will remain as it is. I think this is R1 and R2, we will confirm it. So, it is R1 and R2 and then it is completed like this. The voltage source is of V volts. So, there are no particular or numerical values given. We have to get the expression in terms of maybe R1, R2 and V. So, now we have to calculate first the values. What is happening at t equal to 0 minus? So, because this is a open switch here, there will not be any voltage across this capacitor. Had this switch been closed, we may then might have written here some voltage. So, because the switch is open, we will write Vc at 0. Now, what is this Vc? Vc is nothing but voltage across this capacitor. So, this Vc at 0 minus is nothing but equal to 0 volts. Now, well, in diagram, they have given Ic and IL. So, we will write it here. Ic, here it is IL at 0 minus, both at 0 minus. So, again that current also will be 0. This Ic current will be 0 ampere. This IL, see it is a short circuited. So, IL current, but because switch is open here, again IL at 0 minus is going to be 0 ampere. And that is enough right now. So, now we will draw the circuit for t equal to 0 plus. So, for t equal to 0 plus, we know that this switch will be getting closed and t equal to 0 plus, inductor will act as open circuit and the capacitor will act as short circuit. So, one more. So, at t equal to 0 plus, again the same circuit, switch is closed now. Well, we know that capacitor is short circuited. So, this is short circuit, the capacitor, and inductor is open circuit. This is R1, this is R2. You can refer it here. So, IC and IL also will write. This is nothing but IC at 0 plus. This is IL at 0 plus. Now, it is quite clear that because this is open circuit, IL I'll write here IL at 0 plus will be 0 ampere. And well, IC at 0 plus, see, now the circuit will be operating because now the switch is closed and the current will flow. It will not flow through here, but it will flow through this short circuited path. So it will, I'll just mark it and so on. So this is the, will be the direction of current. And so we will be able to calculate IC at 0 plus, and that will be, current is voltage upon resistance. So it will be V upon R1. Now, if you want to know what is VC at 0 plus, that is voltage across capacitor, because it is going to be short circuited, it is going to be 0 volts. So one thing we got, that current, capacitor current at 0 plus instant is V upon R1. Well, now we will draw the general circuit. So for that, we will go back to the original diagram. And from this circuit, when the switch is closed, you will come to know that these two points will have same, these two branches will have same voltage. This is the voltage V, and whatever voltage will appear, we will give name to this. So we will draw one diagram again. And this capacitor, we will draw the same diagram. C, and here it is V1 of t, here it is V2 of t, and this can be called as VC, voltage across capacitor. Now you can see the voltage across this capacitor is VC, so that I am writing here as plus minus VC here. Well, not completed the circuit. This is V volts, it is R1, this is R2, this is L. And this voltage will be the same voltage which is across these two terminals. So I will mark it with red pen. And that voltage is nothing but going to be, because they are in series, V1 and V2. So I can write this V1 plus V2 is the same voltage which appears across this capacitor. So I will write one statement that VC is equal to V1 plus V2. Now this is the important statement. The reason is, if you see the question, we are supposed to find V1, V2, V1, V2, then d by dt of V1 and d by dt of V2. So because we have to find it at 0 plus, V1 and V2, okay, we have to write it at 0 plus yet. So we will first write it at 0 plus. Well, voltage across this V1 is going to be 0 and V2 also is going to be 0. So at 0 plus, V1 at 0 plus is going to be 0 volts, because this is going to be open circuited. And V2 also is 0 volts. These are the same two points. V2 is voltage across this resistor. V1 was voltage here. And at 0 plus, both are going to be 0, because these two points are at short circuit, means their voltage will be 0. So now V1 and V2 are definitely sum of both, means V1 plus V2 is equal to this total voltage which is across this A and B. So V1 plus V2 is 0, and we can prove that both are 0. So at 0 plus, V1 and V2 both will be 0. Now coming back to the general equation, we have got equation as VC equal to V1 plus V2. Now what we will do, we will take differentiation of this equation with respect to time, because we want dv1 by d2 and dv2 by dt. So differentiating, with respect to time, what I will get, d by dt of vc is equal to d by dt of rhs. So I will get d by dt of vc is equal to d by dt of v1 plus d by dt of v2. Now again make a box to this. Now we'll go one by one. What is this vc? Vc is nothing but voltage across capacitor, and we know that vc is nothing but equal to, what is the voltage across capacitor? It is nothing but equal to 1 by c, integration of IDT and the limits. If you are doing it for time greater than 0, which we are doing, or we can do it, it will be 0 to t. You can also write minus infinity to t. So, but from minus infinity to 0, it will be 0, and otherwise it will have some value. So, Vc is equal to 1 by c 0 to t I dt is what we have. Now, we need to know what is d by dt of Vc. So, we will take differentiation of this equation, which will result in d by dt of Vc. Now, differentiation and integration will get cancelled. So, it will be simply I upon C. Now, this I is nothing but the current which goes through the capacitor. So, I will mark it as IC. So, IC upon C. Now, we got d by dt of Vc. Because we have to get what happens at 0 plus, we will directly get d by dt of Vc at 0 plus. That is going to be IC at 0 plus divided by C. C is a capacitance, which is a constant. And IC at 0 plus, we have already got at t equal to 0 plus. When we analyze the circuit, we got IC at 0 plus as V by R1. So, I will substitute instead of IC 0 plus equal to V upon R1. V upon R1C. So, one thing we got in this equation, first thing we have got, I'll mark it as 1. Now, second is d by dt of V1. So, what is V1? So, V1 is nothing but the voltage across inductor, and we know that the voltage across inductor is L into di by dt. So, we'll write it. Now, V1 is equal to L into dIL by dt, where IL stands for inductor current. And well, from this equation, we can write dIL by dt is equal to V1 by L. We'll keep it as a note. The reason is quite simple. If you check the V2, V2 is nothing but voltage across resistance R2, and voltage across any resistance will be R into I, that means R2 into current which is passing through this resistance, and it will be the same current. See, it will be the same current which passes through this inductor, and that is nothing but IL. So, whenever you are writing equation of voltage for this R2, you will have to refer the inductor current, because inductor and resistance are in series. So, what we will do for R2, the voltage across R2 will be R2 into IL. Why we are writing this VR2? The reason is, you see this equation, this is important equation, you mark it as equation number A. We came to know what is d by dt of Vc, which is this. So, that was equation 1. We can say that this is equation number 2, dIL upon dt equal to V1 by L. And now, we have to know what is d by dt of V2, and V2 is nothing but voltage across resistance R2, and that R2 which I am talking is this one. So, V2 is nothing but this voltage across R2. So, that I am writing directly now. We can write VR2, that is equal to V2. VR2 means voltage across resistance of, or not resistance, R2 it is. So, it is called as V2, which is given in question. So, V2 is equal to R2 into IL, or V2 equal to R2 into, now instead of IL, so now you can see V2 is R2 into IL, but we don't want V2, we want d by dt of V2. We want d by dt of V2. So, we will take the differentiation d by dt of V2, that will be R2 will be a constant coming out, and d by dt of IL. So, we got dV2 by dt is equal to R2 into dIL by dt. So, that is nothing but equal to dIL by dt is equal to V1 by L. At equation number 2, we have written it. So, d by dt of IL is V1 by L. Here is d by dt of IL. So, that I will write as here R2 into V1 by L. So, we have got d by dt of v2, but we have not written it for 0 plus. So at t equal to 0 plus, we will write d by dt of v2 at 0 plus equal to r2 into v1 at 0 plus divided by l, because we are writing this as at equal to t, time t equal to 0 plus. So v1 at 0 plus is what we have already written. V1 at time t equal to 0 plus is nothing but 0 volts. So this is actually equal to 0. So if you come to this equation, we already got the first term. Yes, equation number 1, d by dt of vc, we have got it. Then d by dt of v1 is what we will get it now, and we got this term equal to 0. So we will substitute equation 1, 2, and you can call this as equation number 3, d by dt of v2 at 0 plus, and I will call it as equation number 3, and then I will write substituting equation 1, 2 and 3 in equation number capital A. Substituting equation 1, 2 and 3 in equation A. So this is nothing but equation A, and this is equation 1, this is equation number 2, and this is equation number 3. So 3, once you substitute this equation number 3 here, this equation number 3, this term will become 0, and then you will directly get dv1 by dt. So you will get dv1 by dt is equal to d by dt of vc minus, this term I am going to take it at left hand side, d by dt of v2, and you can refer to equation 1, d by dt of vc is v upon r1c minus 0. Well, this all is at 0 plus. All these equations are at 0 plus. So dv1 by dt is equal to v upon r1c. Well, also what we did, we just substituted equations in this equation and we got this term dv1 by dt, and this dv2 by dt is nothing but is equal to 0. That was also one of the required answer, dv2 by dt at 0 plus. So thus we have got all the answers. This one also we got dv2 by dt at 0 plus equal to 0 volts. This is also in volts. And then I guess we required v1 and v2, and v1 and v2 at 0 plus were both 0. V1 at 0 plus equal to v2 at 0 plus equal to 0 volts. So thus we have got all required parameters. So thank you for watching this video. If you have any queries, you can comment it. And we'll recommend that you need to practice more and more numericals. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe to Ikeda. Thank you.